Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm a very good one. I hope that you're clear with my voice. Actually, last week I promising to my beloved student, Zarif and Hafiz to have this topic three, but Hafiz said that unfortunately for this topic three and four, we get from different many different textbooks. Okay, so. Basically for this textbook, I do not have a proper slide giving a time for me because this is the first time I thought for this subject. So I just repeat to you all, I need a time. So in order to make sure that we still on track with the syllabus, I try my best by having these things. And then, yeah, this is what today you can see. I just scan it. And then I find my best, inshallah, student. I will provide you with the slide. And then I will share in the NEO. By the way, I already uploaded these notes in our NEO. So make sure, NEO platform. Okay, make sure you log in. As usual, you can retrieve the notes from there. And then, of course, I will put also this video, recorded video lecture inside our NEO platform. And as usual, if you have any question, please do not hesitate to just jot down and shoot in our group, official WhatsApp group. And yeah, that's it. Okay, so without further ado, I will moving into our topic three today. So topic three in our syllabus is topic three. However, in the main reference textbook is under chapter two. Because we already done with our topic two, so now we go with the topic three. Okay. By the way, okay. So what is the topic three? It's about accident theory. So for your information, learners, and to all the viewers, I do this purpose. I have to make sure that we keep on the intellectual property, right? So this is the thing I said that this subject is for DRM 3236. I have to do this watermark to ensure that, the knowledge can be shared, but we have to respect the owner. So this is goes into whatever that I'm sharing to you all is for the purpose for this class. Okay, of course. Okay. And for those who are the viewers who want to gain some knowledge about this topic today, I'm so sorry if there is a noise, okay, behind me here. So yeah, that's it. Okay. So without further ado, I keep saying without further ado, but still not start, right? Right? Okay. So what is this chapter all about? Okay. So chapter three, or as indeed there is in the main textbook is chapter two. So it's about accident theory. So we will learn about the theories that involve what currently and previously happened, okay, in our life, especially in the workplace. Okay, we have to know that what is a theory is all about and how you relate with the accidents. Okay, so I believe that Prof. Sariwati is making this book for all of us and for beneficial to everybody to make sure that we gain the knowledge from here. Okay, for the synopsis, you can see for this chapter, okay, they say in here state. The accidents occur in the various accidents and theories. It also provide a detailed insight on the cause and effect. So it will be mostly discussing and prominently highlighted on what is the cause and what is the effect on the accidents of the human life, property damages, and to the other losses. And all the incidents incurred high accident costs. Of course, every time when the accident occurred, it will relate to the cause. That is number one. For the management concern on it. Okay, so what is the topic objective or the chapter objective for this topic? Okay, number one, of course, to define the accident and elaborate on the type and the cause of accident. Of course, okay, students, Zarif and Hafiz, so this is mainly in our syllabus. We have to know that, number one, we have to know what is the accident is all about, and the types and also the cause. And second one, we will explain and discuss the theories of the accidents. And the third one, we will describe the effects of the accident in human life and the organization and accident cause that have been introduced in the earlier part of the synopsis. And of course, at the end of this topic, okay, we might know what is described accident, near miss, and injuries. And then we describe and apply the accident theories, relate and analyze types of accident, the cause of accident, and the effect and accident of the workplace, at the workplace, and develop the creative ideas and the program to prevent accidents at workplace, of course. Okay, so mostly we very normally norm with the quote, prevention is better than cure, right? So this is related to our topic, of course. And if you can see, as the introductory part in here is about the accident cases, okay, that have been compiled. And this is about Department of DOSH, okay, who has started to do the investigation at Jaya Supermarket, which in section 14 PJ. And this is regards to what we call a fire, fire accidents happen, okay. And you can see in here, they assist the investigation to determine the root cause of the 7 killed Indonesian workers. And then in here, according to the Ministry of Housing and Local Government, this is a municipal agency, okay, and the Construction Industry Development Board, CIDB, and the contractors also will go under the investigation. And so according to these cases, Jaya Supermarket have demolitions, okay, meaning to say a story, 4-story building, 4 bangunan ni, at the time 20 to 30 Indonesian workers was working on the site, and there is a witness called Syed, not Syed Sadiq, okay, but Syed Ahmad Aidid, heard the loud explosion, the topan yang sangat kuat, just like a thunderstorm, and the building was there, and they say there is a brick fall onto the car, his car, the witness say. And they have a very thick white smoke, meaning to say kepulan asap yang tebal and debris is flying everywhere. Debris is referring to the building, okay, parts and materials. And then you can see a big concrete just slap fell on the colleagues. And of course, the crane start to run. And about 20 workers, including the witness and the maid, decided to walk away, of course, to buy drink from my friend. And once and suddenly, they saw the top floors of the building start to fall. That is like the injuries and the accidents happened during, remember, 11 September in United States. So it's like fall down. And then they sit here, there were 9 workers who are working at the ground floor, did not manage to escape. Unfortunately, when the accidents happen like that, of course, who are at the lower ground will be the most affected, right? Because it's like from fall from the top to the bottom, okay? And then they say in here, they were buried in the massive rubbles, okay? And 2 were seriously injured, were sent to University Malaya Medical Center, PPUM, and a total of 155 personnel from Bomba Fire, fire gate member, fireman, smart JPA, okay, 3 and relative was summoned to carry out the search and rescue. So this is like the true case study from Berita Harian, not Berita Harian, Berita Harian, 29 May 2009. So this is, I think that if we can relate with the current issue, if you still remember in MRR2, nearby to our Shiraz Highway, there is also a few workers from Bangladesh. So Bangladeshi workers were accident and die. They have that fatality due to the collapse of the highway, okay? And due to the accidents happened because one lorry is bucked into these things because the height is not at the right level. And what happened, it's just, yeah, collapsed to the old construction site. Okay. Bila ketinggian lori tu tadi melampaui daripada bangunan tu. Mereka sedang buat construction kan. Jadi melanggar dan akhirnya pekerja-pekerja bangla tersebut mati di tempat kejadian. Okay, so there's almost similar cases that what happened. And then, as you can see in here, this is the accident case too, which is regards, this is a 10 died, including a doctor from Hong Kong. Okay, and then there will be like North South Expressway heading towards South. Okay, tangkap yesterday. So this is involved like injuries from, I think that in the bus, okay? The chief operation officer Wan Azlan said the victim who died on the spot was sitting in the front of the bus and they were pinned down by the bus while the others injured as they were pinned to their seats. 14 of them aged 11 to 60 years old were injured and were admitted to hospital and they received outpatient treatment while the two drivers suffer from the minor injuries. The driver might be still safe, okay, whereby the scene of accident, devastating and nightmare, the blood is everywhere because when you are in the bus, actually, you have to take a high risk. Every single of the transportation that we take, actually, we have the risk. That's why when you bought a ticket, for example, like a bus or the flight ticket, you have to also buy the insurance. Do you know that one that is actually the life insurance? And I believe that is regards to the transportation that you use and transport and commuted and commuting actually is about risk. We do not know what might be we facing in the future, right? Okay, and then you can see in here we finished the rescue mission about 6:45 morning because it's very difficult to remove all the victims and the crane to be used to lift the bus so they can get the victims. I believe that all the victims is inside and trapping in the bus. Okay, and investigation showed the bus that carried 28 passengers lost control when traveling down here and rammed into a tree before it overturned and ripped off. Oh, I cannot imagine because the roof of the bus is just flipped to balik. And the bus was also found to have released summons. See, meaning to say the bus itself is actually not in the good condition and did not go for the puspakom. Puspakom is whereby the place whereby they do that some inspection, whether they do some maybe changing or maybe do some alterations toward the transportation or any vehicles. You have to go and pass their inspection, then you can use well and safely. Okay, inspection before the journey. Okay, so meaning to say they have the illegal cases on this. All right, so in here, this is a few. This is also from Berita Harian, which is happened in 2008. Okay, 10 maut tersepit di bawah bus. Masya Allah, I feel like very, yeah. Can you imagine that? This is so, even we just read it and we can imagine how it's very difficult, right? How tragic, okay, the accident itself, okay. So there are actually many work accidents that happens in Malaysia, cases, okay, and one major ones will be reported to the local mass media, and somehow the another accident we do not know how much is not being reported, right? So in here they said, however, many big multinational companies, huge oil and gas company, and major construction firms are taken proactive measure in managing OSH. According to the statistic, if I'm not mistaken, students in 2013, okay, it's been stated that mostly, okay, 98%, okay, the high risk of the accident is happened in the construction industry. Jadi risiko yang sangat tinggi ini kebanyakannya berlaku pada industri-industri yang melibatkan pembinaan because the risk is everywhere, okay. And then if you can see from here, it's have many certified with OSAS 18,000, okay, and 18,001, and then 1999, or we have MH1722 2005. Okay, this is what all about the certification related to the safety. And then nevertheless, you have seen or many some cases or work accident that happened in the local media and captured by the public attention. And how does these cases is really related and react toward us when we read it and how we ponder why the accident happened. Do you remember or not? One last time, I think that maybe like around 2 years ago, regarding one of Tafiz, okay, Tafiz, Pondok Tafiz in Datuk Keramat, okay, it's been accident, fire in a fire burning, and it have made all these students, okay, especially those the Tafiz kids, okay, have been died during that particular day. They are been trapped and they cannot go out. And even I'm telling you that now, okay, mashallah, we have to recite Al-Fatiha to them, okay. Yeah, okay, no one safe inside that, right? They've been trapped, okay, due to, I believe that the Pondok Tafiz itself also, they have many some of the clueless on the safety, okay, the part of how the building it be made, okay, and then how it's really meet the requirement to build up as the one of the institution for Islamic religion, right? Yeah, it's a very sad moment of the story. We can imagine that every single of the kids and the Pondok Tafiz is asking for help, right? They are burning, okay? Yeah, mashallah, Allah loves them so much, right? Okay, so yeah, they have more in here. Accident cases 3. This is happened in Aeon, Jasco, Jajesco, okay? Which I do not know where is it, but I believe, yeah, of course, they have this happened in Malaysia, and this happened during they said the mall start to kill the business on 21st, the Christmas. Of course, the explosion occurred in the food court, okay? So this is start from the accident happened in the food court, ground floor, okay? And then they have this three-story complex from 1 p.m. and the workers and tenants were busy making final preparation for their opening, okay? And what happened, they have 2-meter wide hole in the wall, showering glass and debris over 25-meter radius and caused the fire, okay? So yeah, this is in the Johor Bahru, in the Johor, which is in Batu Pahat, and they flying debris while 20 others were being treated in Malacca Hospital with 6 critical. I think because why they go to Malacca Hospital, because Batu Pahat is nearby, okay, that is one of the most safety and nearest to them. And Fire and Rescue Department, Malaysia Energy, there is Department DOSH doing possibility leakage of human error. The building was purged with the trap gas. So this is come from the gas. I believe the cooking gas, right? This section of the food court affected, and there will be explosion was still unsafe as there was a danger that loose to the panel would collapse. So this is during 2009. So meaning to say when they want to start to open the mall, all of a sudden these things happen. Some said it might be due to some people boycotting on their business. So we cannot just say it, okay? We must listen to the DOSH inspection and what is the accident, how is the accident cause and effect towards this business itself, okay? But I believe that this is not just a very common, okay, that we have take a lot of precaution before we started the business itself, okay? Especially it's have the high risk in the part of the food court department. Okay, what is accidents? Okay, so we start with what is accident in here, okay? As you can see, mashallah, all sudden this have to be zoom in, zoom out here, okay? So what is accident? Okay, basically when we talking about this accident, I hope you can listen clearly my voice here, mashallah. Okay, accident is an occurrence. Sorry, I have to open it, but it's so hit here. Okay, accident. Okay, what is accident? Accident is occurrences arising out or in connection with work which resulted in a fatal injury or non-fatal injury. Okay, so this is according to OSH NEDO Port Regulation 2004. So be stated that this is something that occurred to, whether it a fatal injury or is non-fatal injury. It involved directly. There is injury, kecederaan yang tidak melibatkan kematian, non-fatal injury ataupun fatal injury. Meaning to say kecederaan yang sehingga menyebabkan kematian. Okay, an accident is the undesired event. We don't ask for accident, right? We don't please happen the accident. We don't even pray for it. Na'uzubillah min zalik, okay? So an accident is the undesired event giving rise to the death, ill health, injury, damages or other loss. So this according to OSAS, okay? 18001, okay? 2007 standard. All right. So if you realize in here the keywords and the similarity between this, okay, you can see it, they have the word injuries, similarities on it, that is a keyword. So whether they have two probability happen here, you go for fatality for injury or you go for non-fatal injury. You still injured but not goes to the fatality. So which one is a very, very high risk? Of course it goes to the fatality. Yang menyebabkan sehingga kematian itu berlaku adalah yang terlalu berisiko. So what is then accident? I'm so sorry student if let's say it's not so clear in here, okay? I hope it can help you, but this is the best I can prepare for you, to my beloved student. Okay, what is incident? Incident and accident have a two different meaning. Okay, as you can see in incident, as you can see in here, accident, incident. Okay, incident is defined as unexpected, unplanned event in the sequence of event that occurs through the combination of the causes which result in a physical harm, injury, or disease to end the injury, a near miss, a losses, or combinations of the accident. Okay, this one I will go through. If let's say it's not so clear, I will make it clear to you all. Okay, all right. So basically, what we trying to say, this is almost, of course, it's unplanned. Okay, and of course, it's unexpected because it's the thing that we have to talk, we have to bear in mind that it's something that goes to the combination that harm us. Okay, injured, and there might be a disease. Okay, and you can see here incident. Happen, okay, an accident is an event that gave rise, they have the keyboard here, gave rise to an accident or had the potential to lead to an accident, okay. An accident is any accident, so this is according to OSAS 18001-2007, and the incident is any accident, dangerous occurrence, occupationally poisoning, occupational disease or near miss that arise out of or in the course of the world. Okay, so of course, okay, ia adalah satu event, can I say event, satu peristiwa, okay, yang akan menyebabkan, yang akan memberi rise, yang akan memberi salah satu faktor kepada berlakunya kemalangan, and they have potential to lead to accident dan mempunyai satu potensi untuk cenderung ke arah kemalangan. Okay, so an accident is any accident. Incident is any accident yang akan berupa, incident ni adalah sesuatu tragedi yang akan seolah-olah kemalangan. Okay, any accident, dangerous occurrences, sesuatu peristiwa yang boleh kita kata berbahaya, occupational poisoning, okay, pekerjaan yang mempunyai unsur-unsur keracunan, okay, and then occupational disease, ataupun kita kata disease, disease ni penyakit lah, or near miss, atau seolah-olah yang akan berlaku rapat terhadap kita kata arises out, okay, yang akan berlaku kepada cause of work, yang akan menyebabkan berlakunya sebab kepada pekerjaan tersebut. Jadi kita tahulah benda yang hampir-hampir akan menyebabkan kemalangan walaupun mungkin dia adalah bukan, which is not actual happen, but it can be happen. Okay, and accident is unexpected or unplanned events. Okay, of course benda kita takkan cuba cuba untuk rancang pun berlaku. Okay, kita akan cuba elakkan. We try to avoid anything that happen. And this is a multi-causality and sequence of event. Ia akan menyebabkan berlaku banyaknya. Multi-causality, maksudnya cause-cause. Cause ni punca. Apa-apa punca yang boleh kita kaitkan yang mungkin akan berlaku kepada kemalakan tersebut. And any sequence of event. Sebab tu kalau kita berlakunya sesuatu kemalangan, we try to remember back how what is the cause, and we started to throw back, right? We start to remember the sequence, how it happened. In the past 1 hour before this, what I did, I remember that I opened the gas. And then I cook something on the stove, and I don't remember. I take my laundry, and then I try to draw. Go outside, and then take that. All of a sudden, yeah, I heard something, a big noise. So you try to actually tell the person, okay, maybe they want to investigate how it happened, right? So that is the sequence of event. You telling someone who are person in charge to investigate about the matters, and its effect includes injuries, okay, yang akan menyebabkan kecederaan, occupational disease, damages, near miss and losses that arise out or in the course of work. So this is according to MS Nation Standard 7022, which is 2005 standard. Now is already 2015 standard. This is according to the audit requirement. And then the accident represents a serious detriment to productivity, quality and competitiveness and reputation to an organization. Of course, when there is an accident happen, it tarnishes the image after all. Of course, people in the side mind will say, oh, this is like indirectly marketing. Indirectly marketing is, let's say, they have a positive things happen, right? But this thing indirectly is portraying that the image of the company and organization who didn't take care, okay, about the conscience of the safety and health. So this is something like negative perception. So we don't want to say this is something like marketing to the company, but this is the serious detriment. Detriment ni adalah sesuatu yang kita kata yang serious dipandang sesuatu yang melibatkan kepada productivity. Productivity syarikat, quality and also the competitiveness. When you are competing with your rival able to go better than you, whereby you are producing the same thing. Okay, so this is have to go with the ponder why it can be tarnished the image and reputation of the company. Alright, so the next one, we go with the major accidents. Okay, so as you can see in here, the major accident refers to occurrence of the major emission, fire or explosion resulting from uncontrolled development in the course of the industry activity. Okay, which lead to the serious danger to the person, whether immediate or delay, or inside or outside an installation, or to the environment and involving one or more hazardous substances. So this is according to OSHA, CIMS, CIMA, okay, regulation 1996. So it's about major emission. Ini menyebabkan sesuatu yang boleh menyebabkan kebakaran dan juga letupan. Apa juga berlaku dia sesuatu yang kurang, kita kata uncontrolled, dalam kurang kawalan ataupun di bawah kawalan kita. Okay, and a near miss accident means any accident that the place of the work, okay, which has the potential of causing injuries to any person or damage to any property. So dia banyak, okay, definition under OSHA SHC regulation 1996. Okay, so they have a lots of these what we call some of the priorities on the fact they has the cases here, okay, but after all, I don't want to go with this case, but I will proceed on what is types on the cause or the cause of the accident. Okay, basically, if you see from here, okay, they have many of multi-causal in nature. Okay, they have some particular and the causes of accident, banyak jenis dan banyak punca berlakunya kemalangan. Okay, so the first one, we go with the accidents. Okay, they have the impact on collisions. Okay, they have droning, lemas. Impact collision ni macam boleh kita katakan, maybe I have to check on this. Okay, runtuhan, runtuhan, and then droning, lemaslah, ataupun yalah droning kita akan kaitkan dengan lemas. Chemical burns, berlakunya pembakaran bahan kimia, okay. Fire and explosion, kebakaran dan berlakunya letupan, ini collision ni runtuhan. Slip and falls, yang ini berlakunya macam tadilah, apabila berlakunya kegelinciran, slips, and fall, jatuh, and even we have a very slips, like everywhere, maybe there is a cleaner sisters, aunties who are clean the toilets, and aunties cleaner is put some signage, do not cross the floor is slippery. We just go to the toilet and what happened, we slip and then we fall down, that also can occur, the accident happen, okay. And then medical implication, when you take a certain medication and then what happen, you become something like allergies, or maybe you fainted and sometimes all sudden your heart is what we call fast, not fast attacking, but they have a very effective, so not effective, they affect, okay, your condition, it can be something wrong with the medical indication, and somehow you are allergic to certain of medications, and all sudden your face, everything, your body becomes swollen, okay, bengkak ke, so that is the effect can be happen. Right, so over exertion, okay, so they have a few, if you can see, and we have six, okay, the types and the cause of accident happen. So the first one, maybe we look into what is the over exertion. Okay, over exertion is the result when the employees work beyond their physical limits, and it may be in the form of tiredness, okay, lethargy, loss of mind, concentration, jitteriness ni kita like shaving, okay, shaving, shivering, okay, shivering ni kita menggeletar, shaving kita cukur, okay, shivering, sleepiness ni kita dalam keadaan yang letih, mengantuk, kurang tidur, and loss of focus. So this is all related, especially when you go for the work overtime. And what happened? Number one, you become exhausted, and you exhausted, you tiredness, okay, and then lethargic, meaning to say you start to have a very low energy, okay, loss of mind, concentration, because you already exhausted, okay, burn out, and of course you start to have like shivering, like I said just now, because maybe number one of your exhausted level, your burn out level is already to the peak, okay, keletihan yang melampau, okay, and then you menggeletar, if let's say you hunger, you thirsty, okay, and then sleepiness, you have less of your rest, because our body is like robot, you know, not robot, it's like machinery, okay, you need rest, okay, you need rest, somehow you cannot work like robotic, of course, if even you work 24 hours, the robotic also will explode, okay, and then, they said in here, loss of focus, so your mind concentration elsewhere, even people talk to you, you don't even focus, okay. And for example, lorry of bus drivers, because they work night, day and night shift, okay, and they have many what we call shift, okay, and kita panggil apa tu, the movement, okay, the bus, okay, and they have many of yeah, shift, right, on that, and then technician and operator somehow, okay, they have to get ready and stand by for 24 hours, and then also for those who are work for long hours, for example, like doctors, even like our frontliners, staff nurse, okay, so especially during this pandemic, you can imagine on it, when I said the frontliner, they're very exhausted. And I really feel like a very, very sad moment, you know, when they are very exhausted to until they feel that there is no other day, you know. They just sleeping on the floor with the PPE, because to use that PPE, they cannot waste it, right? Because it's very limited. If you still remember 1.0, how it happened, right? In the hospital, they just have to serve, okay, those people who are affected by COVID-19, and then they are crying, okay, because they are very exhausted, but they have to make sure that they can serve the society as well, okay. Until today, alhamdulillah, we can heard a very good news. I feel very touched, you know, because when we're talking about this thing, okay, mashallah, this is a trial to us, okay. Until my mic also not even function after I told this you did this thing. This is overexertion, meaning to say that they're very, mashallah, only Allah can repay for what they did to us, okay, their kindness to serve the society and to make sure that everybody can heal from this COVID-19, okay. Inshallah, we pray, every day that the cases will be keep on just drop it and healing it from here, okay. Okay, and then the second one, impact and collisions, okay. So this is something like jatuh lah, macam nak bagi tahu, it's just like bomb, okay. Many work accidents are impact and collisions, okay. Example, workers being struck by falling object. Maybe there has some crane bringing and transporting certain thing upstairs, and all sudden we do not know what happened towards the crane and it's just flat. Okay, I already told these things. I think that to you all during our experiences doing some interview at the Northport, what happened, the big container just fell towards their colleagues, and then the colleagues is asking for help, but during the very noise in the what we call North Port, right, at the ports, it's very noisy, so people not even heard the shouting help on that, okay. And there is a falling object, bricks or wood planks, okay, being struck by moving object, mechanism, vehicles, okay. Somehow we do not know what happened, the crane is moving their own, okay, and maybe somewhere, okay, they are not doing regularly services, okay, certain of the function features of the crane all sudden moving itself, okay. Common example are road accidents, okay, car condition, even the road, everybody are driving in the car, right? What we asking on our mind, everybody are on the road, whether the driver in their mind or not, not everyone are in their mind, somehow they're driving but their mind is elsewhere. So what happened should be maybe turn right, they turn left. I see that once, and they should give, like, for example, very simple signal. They want to go to the left but they give signal on the right. The driver itself, meaning ourself, right? We are in the not in the mind state. Kita tak berada dalam kawalan minda yang betul. Bukan kita tak betul, tetapi ketika tu kita kurang fokus because of the problem. Can be happen, especially during this very tragic, very challenging time during this pandemic. Everybody have their own problems, and then car collision, they keep on having the accident, okay. Hitting or ram into tree, all sudden, like I see once of the YouTube video. I do not know whether this kid is newly to the motorcycle. What happened? She ram, and all sudden is just go to flat to the fences of his house, her house, and then hitting, okay, the fences, and of course the barriers, the pools, bumping into something, even the bumper, right? When you are too fast, okay, you have a high speed on that, you just buck into this bump, and what happened to your car is just, yeah, it's jumping there, right? And then the door, wall, loads and crashing, and also etc. So this is the thing that we have to into the consideration. This can be happen any kind of factors, all right. So we're moving to the slips and falls. So this is another types of this accident in slips and falls. You can be like slippery, kita tergelincir dan kita jatuh. Okay, I have been once in Musola in IIC. When I realized that the floor is very slippery because they have a lot of like, I don't know, the sisters of cleaners, they do their work, right? But even maybe the floor is very slippery because, yeah, every day people take like wudu and then what happened? Maybe, yeah, the floor have to be brushed, you know, when you are not do it like excessive brush. On that floor, that can be like have alga, okay, alga, algae, okay, and then it will become like a moody floor there. You know, moody, dia macam ada dalam kotoran-kotoran dan dia ada macam lumut-lumut. So that's why will be like how to say that there will be slippery on that. And what happened after I take this wudu and bath, okay, yeah. It happens, okay? And slip and falls are mainly from higher altitudes or working at height. For example, for those who are maybe they are very, not allergic, but they have like traumatic on the high heights, pada ketinggian kan, buildings, scaffolding. So this is normal in the construction staff. When you go to construction, they have a lot of stuff there, scaffolding, okay? They have ladders, staircases. Slip and falls are common in high-risk industry or occupations such as construction, okay, shipbuilding, cleaning of the tall buildings. They take their high risk, you know, like Petronas Twin Tower building. There is a cleaner who are mopping, who are cleaning all the windows, you know. So they use a large crane in order to bring those men, and then they have something like a cable tied them and to ensure that they can do the cleaning parts. You can see it, how risk the work are. And then of course they have like cleaning of the tall buildings, installation of the high voltage transmission wires of lighting. This is TNB workers, I believe it. And even though the Telecom Malaysia, that is their job. Slip and falls are common in buildings, floors, office, obstacle on the floor at the worksite, collapse of the platform, structure of building, etc. So they have many factors. Even though in our house itself, we have potential to have these slips and falls. Okay. All right. So we're moving to the chemicals and chemical reaction. Okay. I think that I have to strip like this. Okay. Chemical and chemical reaction, how the response towards the chemical. I don't believe that every human being you can bear with this chemical because this is something like poisonous. Benda yang boleh menyebabkan keracunan. Jadi, accident occurs due to the chemicals handling. Okay, how you handle the chemical, whether you can you must use mask, you must use a very proper of what we call glove, special glove for that. To delivery, how you do it, some packaging on that, and transporting, how you transport using mixing, and after you mix, how much the quantity you cannot exceed the certain level, if not, there will be explode. Macam-macam boleh berlaku lah, huh? And use of the chemical injury resulting from the chemical splash, okay? Because the chemical is something like watery, benda yang tercair, huh? So when it splash and it goes with the burden, so not burden, it's burns, okay? After all, with like maybe we nearby to like, you know what, in our lab sciences, okay, we have like a book, WhatsApp, whatever, okay? And then we have chemical reaction, how it reacts, and inhalations of the fumes. Fumes means bau-bauan dia lah, huh? And the toxic substance and impacts, okay? And of course, when we talking about these fumes and what we call how it's flames. Dia punya nyalaan api ke, it can be react to us if we are not there with it. That's why we have to use the BPE and so forth. Okay, the workers working in chemical processing plants such as pens is like chat. We've been also before in Nippon Pen. I can imagine those, the workers work is like wearing PPE suit, something like you want to go to, yeah, like Sheikh Muzaffar, you know, go to like astronauts, because the pain itself, they have a very high risky chemical, especially when every day you smell the smell of pain. It's not good for your lungs. And then fertilizer, this is also because it's involved like a very sometimes bad smells, right? Because it's like fertilizer, bau baja, petroleums, greenaries, yeah, that involve like even you cannot smell when you fill your petrol for fuel, right, in your car. You're not necessary to smell, not directly to that, even though I know that you have to fill up your fuel petrol or in your car, but it's not recommended to do that. And then food processing industry, of course, is involved that industry. I believe this is factory line, okay? So of course we have to react, okay, to those whatever they use for maybe preservative, coloring, okay, that involved in making these food industries, okay? And then we have lab works, they are exposed, of course the laboratories, they are really exposed to these hazard and accidents, okay? All right, we're moving on to the next one, which is poisoning, okay? Occupational poisoning is the work accident at the workplace or an event that may affect the health of the general public. So poison is about sesuatu yang boleh menyebabkan keracunan lah. Poisoning may be caused by solids and liquids that may result in deaths of the ingestions of the drugs. And you can see medicine, solids or liquid poison, mushroom, jellyfish, whatever. This is all those things, right? Accident ingestion, drinking or eating or poison liquids, contaminated food, kadang-kadang ada berlakunya keracunan pada makanan tersebut apabila berlaku contaminated lah, berlakunya terkata sesuatu yang menyebabkan makanan tersebut beracun lah, liquid food poisoning, and then people working in the laboratories, testing and samplings, dia nak kena try dulu before you ask the consumer to buy your product. Auto spraying, this is involved like in a workshop, in a car workshop, or painting processes, okay? So that's why when the painters, when you have to how to say that, hiring the painters to paint your house, right, for example. So they involve all those things. And then agriculturists or field researchers that exposed to the various dangerous liquids, okay, poisonous specimens, even you want to do laboratories, chemical samples, right? So you have to make sure you get some specimens, samples, virus, animals, even the COVID-19, okay? What we call virus, you can see that laboratories in China, what they did, they do some samples, but they not use the real woman, not real human being inside the lab, but they use something like rat. As usual, rat will be used for the test and samples. And then the rat is actually smelling this virus when this rat is not used mask, of course, right? So what happened? It dies at that particular time. I think they're testing on the Delta virus on this, okay? And then poisoning may be caused by the toxic gases and vapors. Vapors ni asap populer lah. For example, that's caused by the leakage gases and release of the toxic. Okay. And you can see the cause of this. So they have, you can see here, okay. This is the Thai Pearson Triangle effects. So how we want to know how is the potential you go for the fatality or serious accident? It start with 400. This is like the case. Okay, they make like a theories on this. 400 from the population of the people is near miss out there. And from the 400 goes to, I think the ratio is like a 1:5. Okay, 80 from that is property damage, home loss, loss and also income loss, okay, 80 from that. Of course, your damages of property, because let's say it's like in a fire, right, and then your home also we lost, and then of course it goes with the income loss. And then what happened after that, 50 from that, they will have the first aid and rescue cases. They've been actually been saved and bringing to the hospital outpatients, hospitals, patients. And then 3 from that will have lost time, days and losses, and 1 will go for the fatality or serious accident. So this is according to what they believe, okay? And as you can see, The following sections describe the common theories of accidents and causations, namely as causation model, domino theory of accident, human factor theory, and system theory accidents. So there is a case on here. So I want you to read your own, but we will go highlighted on the few of accident that might be happening. Alright, so we moving into the next one. Okay. Okay. Alright. The next one, I think I will finish on the part of the cause and types. Okay. After that, then we go with the domino theory. Alright, so we moving on to this one. Okay, the exposure to radiation causatics. The word accident may be caused due to the sudden exposure or release of the excessive radiation or damaging rays to the human health. I believe, student, the page 8 should be after we done with this thing. Okay. Right? Are you, yeah? Okay, because this one, I believe they have some sentence lost here. Okay, and then it goes to here, okay? Draw poisonous pollutants such as the carbon monoxide, ammonia, nitrate lights from automobile, chimneys, okay? Chimneys ni macam dekat atas kita punya, apa kita panggil? Corong. Corong asap. Okay, dekat atas kilang tu. Ventilation system, for example, workers working in confined manholes, underground tunneling, ni dalam terowong lah, macam kita ada terowong dekat Jalan Ampang tu. And then site or mines are exposed to the toxic gases. Alright. And then we do also have, after we done with this one, we have to go back. I'm so sorry, student, the page is really not accurate here. Okay, but I will tell you on that, okay. And then the drowning is an accident which may include natural disaster. Okay, for example, like drowning in the sea. That is happened lately in the current issue in Kedah, right? If you still remember, they have a few of people have died due to this drowning, okay? Because they have a very heavily rain, and then it become flood. And what happened, the people have been drone on site there, okay. And then the river, unused mining pools, swimming pools at the resort hotel, even though somehow the swimming pool look like it's not so dangerous, but the accident can happen. And the work disaster like occupational such as divers, okay. Yeah, somehow it can happen. Army, marine forces, fishermen and fishing vessels, very disaster. Okay, so you can see from here, the fire and rescue personnel saving life in waters, navy personnel, people working in shipping and fishing industry are highly exposed to drowning accident, especially like fishermen. So this is what happened to them. And then of course we're talking about the fire. Fire is the major accident as a dangerous occurrence. Fire accident cause many serious injuries and fatal deaths resulting from the burns, toxic smells, the smokes, inhalations, and we have asphyxiations, explosion, excessive heat. Bila berlakunya, kita kata kepanasan yang melampau. Sometimes you can see like Kalimantan, all suddenly become a fire burning, like what we call, they call what? Not jungle, but they call something like, it's happened, okay, this fire burning, pemekaran terbuka, this fire burning to this, all the jungles, because they do fire burning, and all sudden, all the place is when they have a very windy day, and then this fire is already spreading to all out, and then it become, kita panggil sebagai haze, yang berlaku di jerebu, okay, so that is, can be happen. Forest burning, berlakunya pembakaran hutan. Actually, they do a very small burning. Dia buat dulu sebab mostly what happened in the Kalimantan when they planted like for example oil palm ataupun coconut tree, diorang terpaksa menggunakan kaedah yang paling murah, this is cheapest cost, in order to do like again plantation, membuat penanaman semula kan. So what they do is, what is the cheapest way, by burning all the soil, and then bila tanah ni dia dibakar dia lebih orang kata subur, okay. So what happened for them, that is a very cheapest cost. When what happened in the effect, it will affect to like Malaysia, it will affect to Singapore, Brunei, nearby all the neighborhood of the ASEAN countries. Ini yang terjadinya. Jadi what happened, it become the forest burning. Jadi dah pembakaran hutan besar-besaran. Huh? Alright, so it can be like excessive heat, fallen burn, metal woods or being trapped in the fire. Fire accident cases are common in buildings, private homes, wooden homes. Kalau rumah-rumah kayu ni senang terjadi. Especially bila ada electricity track, lepas tu berlakunya macam terkata keadaan elektrik yang shock, okay, and then dia menyebabkan kebakaran and forest fire, car collision and explosion. Nak tengok tak kereta terbakar? Ini adalah disebabkan wiring lah. Sebab tu orang kata kalau boleh, janganlah, yang ni kita selalu buat kan, kita charging our phone in our car, right? And actually it's good, okay, because that is the something like technology. But when, let's say the technology is not in a, what we call in a good way, what will happen, let's say it become like the wiring and the electricity in the car itself, okay, is malfunction, and then it can affect the whole of the car. That is car collision, and one time it become explosion. Alright, and then we have extreme heat and temperature. Accident may happen even though it's a rare in nature due to the extreme heat and temperature. It relates to the job they are exposed. They are very exposed to the extreme temperature. For example, like desert. Not desert, desert. Desert. Desert tu makan pemanis lah, pemanis mulut. That is a desert. Desert. Padang pasir, Arctic cold regions that create heat stress, heat stroke. Heat stroke ni dia boleh menyebabkan kematian. Kita rasa kepanasan melampau naik atas kepala, dia akan menyebabkan kita heat stroke. Heat burns, sebab tu kalau heat stroke tak boleh terus letak air. Sebab kita dalam keadaan panas, pasti terus letak air sejuk, misalnya air ice, dia akan menyebabkan the worst condition. Okay. Dia kena slowly daripada kaki, bukan terus letak kepala. Heat burns and exhaustion or dehydration. Dehydration dia akan menyebabkan, kalau kita tengok lips tu kering, boleh pecah-pecah. Ini berlaku kat negara-negara yang panas lah. For example, working the steel mills, traffic policemen, landscape workers, construction workers, workers under the hot sun or the deserts, exposure to extreme cold, amulan, hitam, Christmas, winter and cold. Kalau dia sejuk pula, lain cerita. Maksudnya, dia boleh menyebabkan tangan kita ni is like totally pain and clean, apa jadi pucat, lepas tu boleh jadi biru lah kebiruan dan boleh menyebabkan kematian because we are frozen, okay? Apa cerita frozen tu, okay? Alright, and then this is regarding number 9, exposure to radiation and caustics, okay? Work accident may be caused due to the sudden exposure or release or excessive radiations or damaging rays to the human health. Okay, so exposure to radiation are obvious in hospital. That's why for the woman pregnancy, you are not allowed to go for your x-ray. Please tell those to the examiner, x-ray people, like laboratories personnel in charge that you are pregnant and then you are not allowed to go for this radiation. It's not good for the baby. Imaging or X-ray department, nuclear processing plant, nuclear laboratories which use radiations and rays and light is operation and processes. Exposure to excessive ionized ray may lead to the mutation, lebih jadi mutant lah, and deformed factors in the womb help deterioration. It's not good. So kalau kita pergi X-ray pun, kita tak pergi setiap tahun. Kalau kita masuk universiti ke atau kita need some go for employment, dia memerlukan kita punya medical inspection kan. Kita tak pergi setiap tahun because the radiation itself is very risky. And then for medical complication, work accident may occur in the hospital and even the workplace due to medical complication and error. So it can be happen wrong diagnosis. This is a very malpractice. You can be sued by your patient due to this, especially to those the doctors and the specialists, right? Inaccurate or complicated operations. Suppose you to do A operation and then suddenly do B operation, and what happened to the patient? Wrong medication mix up the patient's records, for example, okay, operation problem and etc. So you can see deaths arising from the occupational hazard are on the increasing trend, for example, chronic illness or the health problems such as a heart disease, okay, cancer, stroke, hypertension, diabetic, acute illness or disease such as H1N1, avian flu, and now is the COVID-19, okay, pandemic, right? Medical hazards such as exposure to airborne germs, viruses, sputum, contaminated blood, infection, medical tools, gadget and equipment. Even though now, do you know, student, my beloved student, we are not allowed to sharing with everything, the utensil you use, you guna garfu, your fork and spoon, and you share with your friends. It's not allowed because this is easily to be contaminated, and you are actually handling, not handling, you are transferring those things. You don't know whether you are the patients of this disease, and then you're transferring to those people who are not should be getting this disease. Okay, so that will be happening. And for like patient AIDS, okay, you are not allowed to be treat like that. Penyakit AIDS dia tak treat lah macam tu. Dia tak berjangkit melalui itu. Tapi yang sekarang ni, COVID-19 kita tidak digalakkan. Sick patients, disease may affect work health over time during the employment. So from the past research, it was reported one fatal or serious accident that occurred. This person is termed as type person triangle. Ini yang tadi kita baca ni. Okay, how its effect, I already goes with that. And for every one fatal serious accident that occurred, there is three loss or perhaps three losses that took place. And all sudden it become here. Okay, so I hope you don't confuse students, because actually this already keep a little bit on these pages. Okay, so the next domino theory accident, I will continue on the next of our topic. Is almost to your class. I will sharing this video. Thank you for now. Thank you for listening up for my lecture. And yeah, please accept any the witnesses of mine. And any question, do not hesitate to just ask in the in the YouTube video below. I will entertain on the question and also in our group WhatsApp. Thank you for now. Assalamualaikum. Stay safe and stay healthy. Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum.